This is a podcast of Scripps Institution of Oceanography at UC San Diego. To learn more about how you can support Scripps, visit us online at scripps.ucsd.edu. Baja California was part of mainland Mexico until about 10 million years ago. Opposing forces between the North American and Pacific tectonic plates caused the peninsula to break away on a slow-motion journey away from the mainland. Today, spreading centers along the seafloor are widening the gulf at the same time that the drifting plates are pushing Baja California cities like Ensenada on a northwesterly route away from the Mexican mainland. The new ocean being born in the Gulf will add to what is currently a shrinking Pacific Ocean. Geologists from Scripps Institution of Oceanography at UC San Diego are using remotely operated vehicles to excavate rocks from deep sea canyons to map the expanding ocean bottom and document the birth of the next ocean basin.
We want to study the structure, the forces that initiated the rupturing. We want to study magmatism. We want to study the transition from continent to a full ocean basin. And the Gulf of California really captures the initiation from continent to a young ocean basin. Okay, it's not really an ocean, it's still a sea right now, elongated sea. But pretty soon, well, geologically speaking, it will become an ocean.
In May 2008, Scripps marine geologist Peter Lonsdale led a month-long expedition to the region. ROV Jason plunged hundreds of feet to the muddy bottom to help researchers collect large chunks of rocks from deep-sea cliffs and outcrops in specific locations along the seafloor.
Previously, hydrothermal vents in the Gulf had only been found in Guaymas Basin, and we found hydrothermal vents in Carmen Basin and Sassipuitas Basin and multiple basins, and so this has never been discovered before. And a few of them actually had the shimmering water pouring out of it, the superheated water that was actually being ejected out of the seafloor.
A magma is a molten hot body, and some of them don't make it to the surface because there's a lot of, for example, in the Gulf of California, there's a lot of thick sediment cover on top. And so this hot body underneath thick pile of sediments will still be hot, and then the water, which is cold from the Gulf, will penetrate and then will be heated and come up. So that's what we call the hydrothermal system. And as the water gets heated up, it picks up, for example, copper or gold and silver from the rocks. It interacts this water, and then it will deposit when it becomes colder. So that's how some of the economic mineral deposits that we mine right now are being performed. So these hydrothermal activities will leach the minerals from one place and deposit it, concentrate in another place. So that's why, continental margins, because right now the Gulf of California is still narrow. So both sides are still continental margins. Baja side and the Mexican side are still margins. And these hydrothermal activities are concentrating economic mineral deposits.
And my research just tells me that there's, this hydrothermal system caused by intrusions is actually happening. These magmas being injected into the sediments, heating it up and driving out the water, evidence being these vents.
It will take a few million years before the new basin forms. Geologists are still unsure what it will look like, or if there are yet unknown tectonic forces that will interrupt its formation. Scripps scientists are preparing future expeditions to sample more rocks along deep sea cliffs in order to learn more about the new ocean forming below the Gulf of California seafloor.
In late June, we're going back out to sea with Professor Sassesi, and we're going to be doing a geophysical cruise, seismic profiling, trying to image these igneous structures in three dimensions instead of just in two dimensions, so we can understand how they interact, not in a 2D, but actually in a 3D realm. And then in October, I'm leading a cruise in the southwestern part of the Gulf, where we're going to be sampling, doing additional rock sampling where we didn't go with Jason. And they're also, this is correlating to my seismic profiles as well, so we can see actually what's going on there. Are these, volcanics? Is it continental crust? Where's the boundary between oceanic and continental crust? So hopefully we'll be able to answer those sort of questions. We'll be right back.
This has been a presentation of Scripps Institution of Oceanography at UC San Diego.